The child is made of 100. The child has 100 languages, 100 hands, 100 thoughts, 100 ways of thinking, of playing, of speaking, 100 always, 100 ways of listening, of marveling, of loving, 100 joys for singing and for understanding, 100 worlds to discover, 100 worlds to invent, 100 worlds to dream.
The child has 100 languages and 100 more, but they steal 99. They tell the child to think without hands, to do without head, to listen and not to speak, to love and to marvel only at Easter and at Christmas.
They tell the child to discover the world already there, and of the 100, they steal 99. They tell the child that work and play, reality and fantasy, science and imagination, earth and sky, reason and dream are things that do not belong together. And thus they tell the child that the 100 is not there. The child says, "No way, the 100 is there."
Bye. And two, Miss Ledoux.
Yeah.
Spanish called Algo de Todo. It tells you all the interesting things we do each day.
today,
maybe some other day.
And parties, the zoo, at the beach, ice cream was everywhere. But as everyone enjoyed the nice cold treat, Logan preferred gummy bears. One time Logan did try ice cream. He took a big bite and his eyes squeezed. As the ice cream melted in his mouth, he got a huge brain freeze.
Never again,
Logan said.
No one was
as upset as one man, that's for sure. It was Logan's Pop Pop, the great ice cream connoisseur.
Please, Logan, please try it one more time. Just try a small bite, your brain will be just fine.
Decided to be strong.
Little bites are the trick.
Countries. What if people had equal rights from the beginning?
What if footballs could sing the national anthem? What if trolls would pop out of a bowl and say, just one piece of candy? What if kids had no education? What if presidents didn't treat our country right?
What if bikes could fly like E.T.? What if everyone was nice?
What if vegetables were desserts and desserts were vegetables?
What if phones could walk and you didn't have to carry them? What if the biggest hurricane was striking our whole country? What if the world stopped rotating?
That would be bad.
What if shoes came off your feet in the middle of the day? What if you could only read?
What if animals were in charge? What if brown people and white people were both treated?
What if vacation was every day
while drinking lemonade?
What if peace was everywhere? What if a soccer ball could eat and drink? What if your teacher ate a brownie for breakfast? What if people didn't care and they kept on leaving trash on the ground? What if people had to use different bathrooms and water fountains just because of their skin color?
What if people could teleport? What if you could eat whatever you want?
Like ice cream sandwiches.
What if every food was healthy? And what if school was every day of the week?
What if doors closed on you? What if teachers didn't know math or reading or anything else? What if people didn't like other people based on how they look? What if teachers didn't get to teach the way they wanted to teach?
What if everyone had 100 fingers? What if we lived underground? What if no cops protected the country? What if Martin Luther King Jr. never existed?
What if Pokemon was real? What if Broncos players were real Broncos? What if there was only jobs for rich people? What if there was no such thing as war?
What if every time you caught a softball, bit your finger? What if the carrots complete their evil plan to take over the whole entire world? What if every country got along? What if everyone was friends?
What if you could literally dive into your book? And what if people stopped harming the environment?
What if you could go inside video games? What if the Civil War never happened?
What if?
Created a poem about a witch and a dragon in Spanish to share with you. Each class has come up with two simple sentences, and together we came up with this poem. We will translate the poem so everybody can enjoy and understand what we are saying.
Marie the Witch and the Dragon by third grade. Marie is a green and big witch. Her eyes and nose are round and big. Her hair is orange and short. Marie the witch is scared. She has seen a dragon, an enormous and old dragon, but the dragon is also scared. Marie the witch and the dragon are both scared.
Sus ojos y nariz son redondos.
learned a poem in Spanish called Tango. It tells you about how we are feeling.
Tango!
Has created a poem about Thanksgiving in Spanish to share with you. Each class wrote 3 or 4 sentences. We made this poem by ourselves. We will translate it for you so you and everyone can enjoy the poem and understand what we are saying.
Thanksgiving Day by 4th grade. I love Thanksgiving. We will all have a party with our families and friends. We will all give thanks. We will give thanks for the love and friendship. We will give thanks for the water, the food, and peace. We will give thanks for the turkey who gave us his life, for the epic fall with its colors yellow, orange, and brown, and we will give thanks for many more things. We will eat a lot. Yes, we will eat corn and fat, delicious turkey. We will eat apple pie, apple and pumpkin pie, and everything will be delicious. I love Thanksgiving.
Todo estará delicioso. on England's moors and laugh and moan in Guinea and thrive on Spanish shores. We seek success in Finland, are born and die in Maine. In minor ways we differ, in major we're the same. I know the obvious differences between each short and tight, but we are more alike, my friends, than we are unalike. We are
Thank you, everyone. This concludes Poetry in the Park. Until next year. Thank you.